The album, Chet Baker in Paris, is widely regarded as the trumpeter's finest, not least because of the wonderfully original compositions and the equally innovative piano playing. The band left the Paris studio enthused by the session and believing they'd committed some important music to tape. However, their joy was short-lived. A few days later, on the 21st of October 1955, Dick Twardzik was found dead in his hotel room. He'd overdosed on heroin. He was just 24 years old, perhaps a genius, certainly one of the most gifted musicians of his generation. His trio session of just six tunes was released by the Pacific Jazz label a few months later. It filled just one side of an LP. Howard Riley again.
If you listen to that trio record, in the context of those particular times, you get a lot of passages in it which anticipate what happened later on in jazz. For example, this passage is where, in effect, he abandons the chord changes, but only for a certain number of bars, and then he comes back to them. So for those particular bars, he's thinking very freely. Also, another interesting thing about him that looked towards the future was his use of form with his actual pieces, with his compositions, if you like.
Twardzik's unorthodox approach to composition is perhaps best illustrated by A Crutch for the Crab, the opening track from his album. Very few pianists have ever been able to pack so many surprises into just 3 minutes. Dick Twardzik's remarkable Crutch for the Crab. In his 4 years as a recording artist, Dick managed just one album apiece with Chet Baker, Serge Chaloff and Charlie Mariano, some radio broadcasts with Charlie Parker, and, as we've heard, half an album with his own trio. That's all the Dick Twardzik there is.